Well, I'm on a new adventure today. I'm heading down to Puntarenas. Puntarenas is a big fishing town, about a two-hour drive from where we live. But I'm doing something different this time. I'm taking the ferry across the Gulf of Nicoya. So I'm in queue right now. After driving for about 2.5-3 hours, we finally got down the ferry line, and I'm waiting to get in. So the next time I should be shooting video will be aboard the Tambor Ferry on the way over to Puntarenas.
Escuchar la paz de las montañas, mirar los colores del atardecer, sentir en mi piel la arena de la playa y lo dulce de la caña cuando beso a mi mujer. Sé que el tiempo lleva prisa para borrarme de la lista, pero yo le digo.
No wind and no waves. We're just cruising across for the next 70 minutes or so, going across the Gulf of Nicoya until we get to our port over in Puntarenas. Not a bad little trip. Well, the trip's almost over. It's been about 70 minutes or so since we've taken off from the port of Pacara. We're about ready to go ahead and round the point over at Puntarenas and get this bad boy stuck on shore so we can drive away and go do some more touring. This really wasn't a bad trip, it was a lot of fun. Very calm, very peaceful. Glad there weren't any big waves. But now it's time to go ahead and get down to the car, find it amongst the mass of everything down below deck, and then cruise on out of here. I think we're gonna head on over to Jacó. We're out of here.
Ay, qué bonita es esta vida. Siempre hay alguien que nos quiere, siempre hay alguien que nos cuida. Ay, 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 qué bonita es esta vida. Y aunque no sea para siempre, si la vivo con mi gente, es bonita hasta la muerte con aguardiente y tequila.
Port of Puntarenas. It's kind of a cheesy area, but loaded with touristy booths, selling tchotchkes to all the tourists who come in off the cruise boat. And oh, by the way, we have a big ass cruise boat that's just pulled in this morning, and now everybody's out doing some day trips. So let's check out the port of Puntarenas. Adventure today is the Tarcoles Bridge, which crosses the Tarcoles River, and it's known for its abundance of crocodiles. So we're gonna see if we can check out some crocodiles from the bridge and keep a healthy distance from them.
Para mí es terrible.
anticlimactic. I made it all the way out to the coastline at Playa Jacó. And I was expecting to see some good waves, maybe even take out my boogie board and ride a few. But no such luck. We got rain, clouds, and really lousy waves. So, there's not really much else left to do, except maybe drive down through the center of town and take a couple of pictures at what Jacó looks like, and then get the hell out of here and go visit our friends Deb and Rob back in Esparza, about 45 minutes to an hour away, where there's a cold beer waiting for us, I'm sure. So, okay, this is it. Let's go ahead and take a quick look-see at Jacó. This is it, man. This is Jacó. No big whoop. A lot of cheesy stores, expensive tchotchke joints, lots of bars, and that's really about it. So I hope you've enjoyed your visit to Jacó. Now I'm getting the hell out of here. Pronto. Vámonos!
Hi, I'm Deb Clipper, and you remember me most likely from episode number 5, and here I am again.
I'm going to spit and grow a spit tree. During the rainy season, anything grows. That's what I mean. So a year from now, there'll be a spit tree there, okay?
Here I am again, episode number, 102. Bienvenidos a mis amigos de Guanilama Esparza in Costa Rica. Y 8 años vivimos in Costa Rica. Y chao.
Ladies and gentlemen, the story you are about to see is true. The names have been changed to protect the innocent.
I've just spent the last 20 minutes talking a damn transit tow cop out of giving me a ticket. I was driving slow, taking it easy. I didn't do anything wrong. I was on a merge lane coming up from Puntarenas, and he says that I cut off cars when there was nobody even in back of me. He was busy writing a ticket to a guy in front of me, and all of a sudden he caught me out of his eye and flagged me over, and he pulled my license. After about 15 minutes of giving me a hard time, the guy turned around. He was gonna write me a ticket for $600 friggin' dollars. You know, I could see if I was drunk, I could see if I was driving 50 miles over the speed limit, but these new traffic laws, I'll tell you, I almost lost it. Bottom line is I was having a rather interesting argument with the cop, and some of that may have even come through on video. But bottom line is, I pleaded with the guy. I almost cried. I don't think I cried, but I went ahead, told him that I had no money, that I lived here in that I lived in Playa Hermosa, and he wound up not writing me a ticket, but making me a much lower fine, $50 out the door. It was either that, or it was take a ticket, take 50 points, I would have lost my license, and I would have been out $600. I went ahead and paid the guy $50.
Whoa!
And with that, I think I'm going to go ahead and bring a close to this road trip. I wish it would have ended on a better note, but that's the way it is in Costa Rica. Hey, this is Andy Brown with Boomers Offshore. $50 poorer, but a little bit wiser. Adios, guys. We're heading home.
Ya te diste cuenta que mi corazón sufre por ti. Y en
silencio lloro mi dolor.